Salivary glands are exocrine glands present in the oral cavity, whose function is to secrete saliva. Saliva is a multifunctional fluid, which has antibacterial proteins, lubricates the oral mucosa, maintains the integrity of teeth, and helps in digestion. So salivary glands are of two types, them being the major and the minor salivary glands. The parotid, submandibular, and the sublingual glands form the major glands, which together secrete 90% of the saliva. Minor salivary glands are small aggregates of secretory tissue and are around 600 to 1000 in number. They are located throughout the oral cavity, except in the gingiva and the anterior part of the heart palate. Though they secrete only 10% of the saliva, minor salivary glands are predominantly responsible for mucous salivary secretion lubricating the oral cavity. Salivary glands are also classified based on the type of secretory cells they possess. Serous and mucous cells are the secretory cells of the salivary gland. Hence, salivary glands are also classified as serous salivary glands, mucous salivary glands, and mixed salivary glands, that is, those glands that possess both serous and mucous cells. So, parotid glands are serous glands, submandibular glands are mixed glands but are predominantly serous, and sublingual glands are also mixed but are predominantly mucous. Majority of the minor salivary glands are mucous, except for von Ebner's glands, which are serous glands. Now, the salivary glands consist of secretory end pieces, otherwise called acini, which communicate with the oral cavity through a complex ductal arrangement. This arrangement, along with the help of myoepithelial cells, helps salivary glands secrete saliva. Secretory end pieces house the secretory cells of the salivary glands. Now, the secretory cells, as enumerated before, are of two types, namely serous and mucous cells. Secretory cells are also called acinar cells, since they are housed in acini, or secretory end pieces. The secretory end pieces are continuous with the main excretory duct of the salivary gland through intermediary ducts. The lumen of the end piece opens into the intercalated duct, which is continuous with the striated duct, which in turn opens into the excretory duct of the salivary gland. Also note that the ducts are lined by ductal cells. Now, the secretory end pieces and the intercalated ducts are associated with stellate-shaped contractile cells called myoepithelial cells. Myoepithelial cells are epithelial cells that also have smooth muscle-like contractile properties. So, one among the many functions of the cell is to contract and help secrete saliva from the acini to the ducts. This architecture of the salivary glands can be compared to a bunch of grapes, where the grapes are the secretory end pieces and the stem or the branches are the ducts. Salivary glands are basically enclosed by a connective tissue capsule that branches into several interlobar septa to divide the parenchyma or the functional tissues into different lobes. These lobes are further divided by interlobular septa into different lobules. A lobule houses secretory end pieces, the intercalated and the striated ducts. Hence, intercalated and striated ducts are called intralobular ducts. Now, striated ducts continue to open into excretory ducts, which are situated in between lobules. Hence, excretory ducts in between lobules are called interlobular excretory ducts. Now, these continue and join other interlobular excretory ducts to form interlobar excretory ducts, which in turn finally open into the main excretory duct of the salivary gland that is continuous with the oral cavity. Serous cells are housed in a spherical acinus and may be 8 to 12 in number surrounding a central lumen. A serous cell is pyramid-shaped with a basal nucleus and numerous secretory granules in the apical cytoplasm. These granules are called zymogen granules and house salivary macromolecules or proteins. The lumen of the serous acinus has finger-like extensions that continue between the serous cells, and these extensions are called intercellular canaliculi. The cells are joined to each other on the lateral surfaces through junctional complexes. And each junctional complex is made of a tight junction, an adhering junction, and a desmosome. Mucous acinar cells are also pyramidal cells with apical cytoplasm packed with mucin granules, and a flat nucleus in the basal cytoplasm compressed by mucin granules. These cells are housed in tubular secretory end pieces, and a cross-section would show mucous acinar cells surrounding a central lumen. Sometimes mucous acini or end pieces may be associated with serous cells arranged on them in the shape of a crescent. This is called a serous demilune. Serous demilunes are very much like serous acini. Now, unlike serous acini, mucous acini lack intercellular canaliculi. However, those mucous acini associated with serous demilunes have canaliculi, and the secretions of these serous demilunes reach the lumen through these canaliculi. Under the light microscope, the mucin granules or the mucin cannot be seen in an H&E preparation since they get washed out. Hence, the cells look empty when stained with H&E stains. However, special stains like periodic acid shift and alchin blue can stain mucin or the mucus. Secretory end pieces are continuous with intercalated ducts. And intercalated ducts are lined by simple cuboidal epithelium and are associated with myoepithelial cells. The intercalated duct cells have a central nucleus and little cytoplasm. Intercalated ducts are very small and are usually not visible under the microscope. Several intercalated ducts join and open into a striated duct. Striated ducts are lined by columnar cells which have centrally placed nucleus and an eosinophilic cytoplasm. The basal end of the striated ductal cell is thrown into numerous deep folds housing several mitochondria. These deep folds give the basal surface of the cell a striated appearance under the microscope, hence the name. These ducts form the main portion of the salivary gland ductal system and are responsible for most of the ionic transport happening in the saliva when it travels from the end piece to the oral cavity. And this is why these cells possess several mitochondria in the basal folds of the cytoplasm. Excretory ducts are present in the connective tissue septa between lobules and are called interlobular ducts. Interlobular excretory ducts fuse to form bigger interlobar excretory ducts, with the main excretory duct opening into the oral cavity. The interlobular excretory ducts are lined by pseudostratified columnar epithelium, and as the ducts get larger and approach the oral cavity, the lining becomes stratified squamous.